It could feel strange to get sleepy and tired after drinking coffee. Caffeine must keep you awake, right? But it happens with thousands of people every day. So I checked through 20 scientific studies to tell why coffee could put you to sleep and how to fix it. Also, I will add a couple of opinions from psychologists, sleep experts, and scientists to make my statement sound more convincing. So let's start. Hi, my name is Alex and it's a late night outside. In this video, I'll talk about the main reasons why coffee could make you sleepy and a couple of simple enough solutions to avoid it. You could watch them in any order you want. And the first reason why coffee could make you tired is that it has too much sugar. It's pretty obvious with sugar and you felt exhausted after eating too many sweets at least once in your life. Still, when combined with caffeine, it's even worse. As provided by the Zhengzhou University in China, caffeine itself could decrease the sugar level in your blood, which could drop your energy levels a bit. You won't notice it because the active boost of coffee is much higher. But what happens if you combine it with sugar, which many people seem to put in their coffee? Or maybe not sugar, but syrup? Or eating something sweet like honey alongside? I mean, you know what happens, you'll get tired, it's in the title of the video. Firstly, caffeine will start working, plus all the sugar you got will make you happier. Usually it's called a sugar rush. It happens because in the ancient prehistoric times, when our brains developed through evolution, sugar was insanely rare. Maybe you'll find some berries or apples somewhere, and fruits mean vitamins, so your brain rewards you with happiness. And today it works the same way. What your brain doesn't know is that you can get a yearly amount of sugar in a single meal. It's a huge topic, maybe it even requires its own video, so make sure to subscribe not to miss it. But what's important is that happiness from sugar rush is always followed by sleepiness from a sugar crash. As provided by the Humboldt University of Berlin, when your body gets so much sugar, it starts producing insulin to normalize the sugar levels. And by doing so, it drops your energy levels significantly, up to sleepiness, fatigue, you name it. It works like a roller coaster. Firstly, you get a lot of sugar, your mood goes up, and your body tries to process it. Then you produce enough insulin to lower the sugar level and it goes down, making you tired and sleepy in a couple of minutes. And the more you repeat the cycle, the more tired you become. So the solution would be pretty obvious. Put less sugar in your cup or eat fewer donuts or any other sugar-heavy food when drinking coffee. I myself prefer to have a nice dinner, then get some raw coffee in and lay down for 15-20 minutes until it hits. It helps a lot to record these night episodes. But getting back to sweets, if your coffee doesn't taste that good without sugar, maybe you need to pick a better one. Because the second reason why you could be tired is that your coffee is too cheap. I don't mean that more expensive coffee is stronger, has more caffeine and so on, it does in a way, but it's not the main reason for this point. The main one is that coffee could include toxins provided by malt, which could be the reason for fatigue and other nasty stuff. And the cheaper the coffee is, the higher the possibility that it had malt. Coffee goes a long way before getting into your cup. It gets collected on fields, then roasted in factories, stored in some warehouses, processed to get instant coffee or capsules, delivered to your country in bags, packed in nice jars to put in shops, and so on. On each of these stages, there could be some failures. Too cold, too warm, too bad, bad packaging, thousands of potential reasons. And if something went wrong, mold could appear on coffee beans. And this mold could produce toxins that make you tired. Of course, it's much more complicated than that, but let's keep it simple for the purpose of the video. The main problem with toxins research is that there is too much research and too little research at the same time. We got tens of studies during the last 20 years, but the topic is still messed up a bit. For example, let's pick the research from the University of Valencia in Spain. It's the latest one I found. The scientists picked 100 varieties of coffee from Spanish supermarkets and tested how much malt toxin they had. 95 out of 100 products were within allowed standards, but the other 5 were outside the limits. decaffeinated coffee, coffee capsules, and decaffeinated coffee capsules with some spooky results. But the problem is, it doesn't prove anything. There are multiple types of mold toxins, and the researchers measured only one, because Europe had standards for only one. So scary numbers and no clarity. Still, 5 out of 100 is not that bad, right? Yeah, but for example, there is another research from the Department of Public Hygiene of Portugal. They tested 60 different samples of coffee and found toxins in more than 90% of the products, like in almost all of them. Sounds even scarier, right? But if you read it through, you see that all the results are below the limits, so it's not that big deal after all. What I want to say is that there is enough information to prove any theory right or wrong if you really want to. Some companies do these studies to blame their competitors. Some provide them as examples of why coffee is worse than tea. Some try to advertise their own product this way, and so on and so forth. But there are a couple of statements that are indeed true, and I propose to stick with them. Firstly, mold toxins truly exist. They could make you tired, affect your health, and most of the coffee products include them. The good part is that their portion is so tiny in average coffee that it's scientifically impossible to affect you in any way. Countries and factories have standards, and high temperature kills everything when coffee is roasted. The bad part is that some cheap coffee manufacturers don't follow these standards as much as they should. So some no-name coffee you get at the nearby gas station, snake stand, or even your office could make you feel bad, especially if you drink it regularly. And the solution is clear: try not to drink cheap coffee. Skip cheap brands you never heard of, and you should do fine. Also, as my personal recommendation, don't ever drink coffee from sticks like 3-in-1, 2-in-1 and so on. Firstly, the cheapest coffee usually goes in these sticks because it's mixed with a lot of other stuff. Secondly, such sticks usually have an enormous amount of sugar, close to 70% of their weight. And as we saw in the previous part, it could take more energy than it gives. And the third one is that the usual cup of espresso has 60-80 milligrams of caffeine, while a stick has 40 if you're lucky enough. So I'm not sure we can call it coffee at all. But on the other hand, getting less caffeine could also help you. I mean, there is a high possibility that most of the people watching this video drink too much coffee. I could even bet that I'm getting at least 2 times less caffeine than you. This episode covers a bit different topic, but another one about 5 signs you drink too much caffeine will be out soon, so make sure to subscribe to get notification. Getting back to why coffee could make you sleepy, the third reason is that you don't drink enough water. However, there are 2 completely different cases of how it could affect you. The first one could be applied if you don't drink caffeine every day. When you start drinking coffee, tea or something similar, it takes your body up to 4 or 5 days to get used to it. But if it's your first cup in a couple of days, as provided by the research from Loughborough University in the United Kingdom, your body will require more water to keep you healthy. The research stated that caffeine doesn't cause any form of dehydration for regular users, so it's cool and we'll discuss it in a second. But new users would need to get to the bathroom a bit more often. And if not followed by drinking more water, it will cause dehydration. As stated by hundreds of studies like this one from the University of North Carolina, dehydration could and will lead to a bad mood, decreased cognitive abilities, and a lot of nasty stuff you don't want to experience. And the obvious solution would be to drink more water, yep. I even have a special fitness bottle for that. It is 2 liters or 70 ounces. There are tons of such bottles on Amazon or similar sites, and most of them are cheap enough. I usually drink close to 1.5 bottles per day, and it seems close to medical recommendations, so yeah, highly recommend you doing the same. But getting back to the topic, if the research stated that caffeine doesn't cause dehydration, then it mustn't affect you if you drink coffee every day, right? Technically yes, but imagine that you're already dehydrated. There could be tons of reasons. Share your ones in the comments if you don't drink enough water. Maybe it's early morning and you didn't have time to get a glass. Perhaps you have a really stressful day, so you don't care. Or maybe you work or study a lot and just forget to drink water at all. Will you feel more tired because of dehydration? Yep, you surely will. How will you deal with sleepiness? You'll get more coffee. Will it help? Maybe it will, or maybe it will not if the negative effects of dehydration outweigh the positive effects of caffeine. It's important to understand that caffeine won't make you dehydrated, right, but it won't make you hydrated also. Adding another complex substance into your tired body won't really help and could make you even more tired. So, be aware and drink more water. Also, if coffee doesn't make you sleepy but just doesn't hit you the same as before, you could have developed caffeine tolerance, and it could be fixed. It's not the point of this video, but one of the next ones. So, stay tuned. And yep, that's all for this episode. Thank you for watching it. It's time for me to sleep. Feel free to like this video or subscribe, it makes a difference. If you want more, check the channel or the recommended ones. And if you have questions or something to say, let me know in the comments. Have a good night.